take and welcome to Taj Usha Kiran Palace. We take you on a walk, which is we call as Heritage Walk, a time through the history, a 140-year history of Taj Usha Kiran Palace. So we start off from our elevator, which was brought from London. We're currently at the terrace of our building, and it's very important to know first of all how Gwalior was formed. So the story goes in a way that there was Raja Suraj Singh who went up the hilltop, and he was suffering from leprosy. He found a saint there and he requested for a cure, and the saint said that there's a pond nearby and you can drink some water as well as you can take bath in that water and your leprosy will be cured. He did the same and he was cured of leprosy. Because of him, the pond was named Suraj Kund, which still exists at the Gwalior Fort. Also, the saint's name was Gwalipa, and in his memory, Raja Suraj Sen made a fort on the hilltop, which is the Gwalior Fort, and the whole city which was built around the hilltop was called Gwalior. On our right-hand side is the Jai Vilas Palace, which hosts the Asia's largest chandeliers, the silver train, and the rich history of the Royal Scindia family. Towards our left-hand side is the famous Gwalior Fort. And right here is the whole city view. Also, the sun sets in this direction, which gives a lovely evening view as well. Before we move forward, let me tell you the history of the Scindia family as well. Initially, the Scindians came from Maharashtra over here. They were the chieftains in the army of Peshwaji. If you look at the history, in about 15th century, this area was ruled by Tomars. And the Tomars were defeated by the Lodis, which was subsequently defeated by the Mughals. So there was a big threat of Mughals entering the middle part of India. So there was a battle which happened between the Mughals and the Peshwaji's army, in which they won. And Peshwaji was very far-sighted, so he gave this area to his one of the chieftains to rule. And he was Ranoji Rao. And Ranoji Rao was the founder member for the whole Scindia dynasty. So that is the history, how being Maharashtrians, they came from Maharashtra and got settled in Gwalior. Also, this was considered as the gateway into the middle part of India. Right. And once the whole, the Scindia rule was established in Gwalior, it became a safeguard for Mughals not entering the middle part of India. So in the end part of the 1880s, the Jai Vilas Palace was being built. This was designed by a foreign designer called Mr. Michael Filos. Primarily it was inspired by the Italian designs, a bit of Korean and Tuscan style. He also thought about where would his guest would be staying. And the whole purpose of this building being built was to host the guest of the Maharaj, and that was the initial basis of the Nav Talab Palace to be built. So the earlier Usha Kiran Palace was called as Nav Talab Palace because it had 9 canals on which it was built, and it kind of showcased a place like Venice. The history of this building starts from 1880s It was initially built by Maharaj Jayaji Rao Scindia. In 1905, there was a visit of Prince of Wales, and he was the first guest which came and stayed here. But Maharaj Jayaji Rao Scindia died in 1886, so the visit was hosted by his son Madho Rao, and that was the first guest which was staying in the Navkala Palace. After this era, there was a golden era of this palace, in which Maharaj Jivaji Rao Scindia came himself and stayed in this hotel. He had five children, Madho Rao Scindia ji and his four sisters. He thought this would be an ideal place for a young family to be brought up. So instead of staying in the main Jai Vilas Palace, they for some period of time stayed in Navkala Palace, and that was the glory period of this place. Also, later on the name of the sister of Madho Rao Scindia ji, the second eldest sister was called Usha Raje, and on her name, the name was changed to Usha Kiran Palace. That's how a Navkala Palace became Usha Kiran Palace. We are at this moment right in front of a restaurant which is called the Silver Salon, a very unique name being taken from the silver train which still exists in the Jai Vilas Palace. This is a beautiful 24 kg silver train which moves on a track on the dining table, and the bottle of liqueurs are kept on top of it. Whenever a guest would need something, they can pick the bottle and the train stops there. Once you put the bottle back, it starts moving again for the request of the other guests. So the name was taken out of that, and we have placed the restaurant name as Silver Salon for Taj Usha Kiran Palace. Also, there's a very unique cuisine which we serve in our restaurant, which is the Nepalese Maratha cuisine. This is the signature royal cuisine which we serve you. We have a royal thali which we do in the restaurant. Also, it's also available on our a la carte menu. The history goes back that the Scindias came from Maharashtra region, so the Maharashtrian cuisine was always the part of the royal family. Also, they got married with queens which came from the Nepalese royal family, so the Nepalese cuisine also entered the kitchens, and that's how the Nepalese Maratha cuisine was there, which we are very proud to showcase in our restaurant. This area we call as the Tulsi Court. We have some of these beautiful small courtyards within our property. The uniqueness about the Tulsi Court is that even in that era, they thought about the natural sunlight falling on this. So the top of the Tulsi Court does not have a roof. Basically, the royal functions which happened during Maharaj Jivaji Rao Scindia's period of time. This is a lovely picture where he's sitting, and you know, this was a style of dining where they sat on chokis and the royal thali is being served to them. In the center of the picture is Maharaj Jivaji Rao Scindia, and you will see within the whole Taj Usha Kiran Palace the maximum pictures of Maharaj Jivaji Rao Scindia, because it was his golden era which was captured in the hotel. Most beautiful part of the building, the filigree wall. This was of course done to enhance the beauty of the place, but it was done in sandstone. So all what you see in the filigree wall is the sandstone being hand carved into these designs. Served two purposes. First purpose was that it also worked as a parda system, so you could go back behind the filigree wall and see who was coming inside the premises, but nobody could see you. Also, sandstone has a cooling effect which helped in providing a natural air conditioning to the building. this has always remained the same from the starting part of the building. And if you see, the east is this side. So when the sun comes out, the first thing is the sunshine would enter the building. Now I'm going to tell the famous story of the snake fountain. Snakes have been always kind of worshipped in the Scindia family. The story goes back that one of the very earlier rulers, he got injured during a battle and he went into the jungle to safeguard himself and he fainted. While the troops came behind, they saw that there were two snakes protecting him from both the sides and were not letting the other animals come near him as well as the sun rays to fall on him. And since then, the snakes found a lot of prominence. They have been included in their national, you know, flag, also in the emblem which they use currently for the royal family. So since that era, you will always see in different places the snake signages being used. Within the hotel, we have prominently displayed them. The signature is right at our entrance, the snake fountain, as well as we have the curtain holders and, you know, on our emblem, everywhere it's being displayed. So the importance of the bell, like in the previous era, the guests are still welcomed by ringing the bell when they arrive into the hotel. What it also leads to is that the team gets to know that a guest is arriving, so they come over to this place and welcome you right from this place instead of guests going up to the reception. We have a lot of musical instruments which are being displayed in this area because we want to tell our guests about the rich music history of Gwalior. Much before Tansen, the musical history of the city started. Maharaja Man Singh, on, you know, his name is all across in the fort. He started this music form of Drupad. He was a very famous musician himself, post which in about 15th century, Tansen, you know, came up. He was a very famous singer in the court of Akbar. It is said, you know, you'll see two versions of the story, that some people say Tansen was born here, but the local people and everybody says that he was born in a village which is 50 kilometers from here, which is Behat, and it's a beautiful place. We tell our guests to go to Behat and see Tansen's home. So we here showcased the two actual carriages which were used by the royal family. What you see here is a phaeton which was used for the men in the family. Right in the picture over there, there is a picture of Maharaj Jivaji Rao Scindia using the phaeton. Right at the back is a coach, which is like a convertible coach which can open from the top and can cover, primarily being used by the Maharanis of the family, so that, you know, it's not open from all the ends and kind of a parda can be maintained. Also, it's a beautiful depiction of the emblem, the royal emblem which was used. You can see the prominence of the snake, and what you see on the side is currently the wolves, which were at that era, it was said that a lot of wolves were found around in this area. So the wolves also were part of the royal emblem. So very blessed to have three temples within the premises. This is the biggest one, also built in the same era, so about now a 140-year-old temple. Was initially meant to be a Shiv temple, but it never had the Shiv statue being placed here till about 2005. And post Taj took over this premises, we thought it would not be nice to have a temple without the statue, and we brought in Lord Ganesha statue for the temple. We thought it will be within the family. You know, Lord Ganesha in Hindu mythology being considered the son of Lord Shiva. So we have placed this statue over here, and we have a pujari which comes every day at 6:30 in the evening when we have an aarti. It's more like a lighting ceremony where we invite all our guests, and they can be part of the ritual. Maharaj Jivaji Rao Scindia had two faithful dogs, and he was very fond of them. Unfortunately, during their stay in the hotel over here in the palace, they both died, and he had a small memorial being built in their memory. So right there lies Sandy from 1943, and just a little ahead we have Vinny. The memory still exists, and we are very proud to have them. One of the most beautiful piece of art is kept here, which is the Lord Shiva statue. This is a single stone carved statue of Lord Shiva. Was initially brought here even before the temple was built. If you see, the whole family of Lord Shiva exists in this. We have Lord Shiva, Goddess Parvati, Nandi, the lion, and Ganesha sitting down. It was initially brought and kept here till the time the temple was being completed. Post the temple was completed, I think there was an attempt where they moved this statue into the temple, but the signs were not right. So it was later on decided that the best place to keep the Lord Shiva statue is under the tree here. So it was brought back and kept here. And over the years, it has been always under the tree. Right behind you can see the tree which was still exists from that period of time. After we took over, we have converted this into a small temple place. Every Monday morning we have a small ritual which also takes place here.
So the first photo you see here is of the Maharaj Madhurao Scindia. He was son of Jai Rao Scindia, who had started this building, and he was instrumental in having Prince of Wales come over and stay here with us in 1905, and in that memory, his bust is being placed. Here is a letterbox of that era, and the best part about this letterbox was that this letterbox was meant for the employees of the royal family, and they could send the letters to their family from here, even if they were far away, it could go by air or by land, and we still encourage our guests to write letters to their family and friends, and to drop them in the letterbox here, so that we can send them from the memories of Taj Usha Kiran Palace. You can get the full view of the royal emblem which is being used by the family. The important part in that is the text, what you see at the base is Ali Ja. It's a Urdu phrase which means, "My Lord is my God." This was a phrase or the title which was given by the Britishers to the Maharaj, so that, you know, it held him in front of all the people, like the status of a god which was already there. It has been maintained in this. Over a period of time, this has also evolved. You see the sun around this, because the warriors were always the sun worshippers in Hindu mythology. That's why the sun, the snake, as we said, the snake were considered the protectors in the family. The bulls, which later kind of became into horses, also kind of are part of this area.
So this is how the Nav Talab Palace looked like when it was built. So you see the whole campus has almost remained the same. There's a bit of piece of changes in the front part which have come in. This is a picture of Jaiji Rao Scindia, who was, you know, instrumental in building the place. And this is the current picture of the palace. These are all postcards which we encourage you to write and send back to friends. We would also like to hand over you a small piece from a filigree wall, which will remind you of the designs which you see within the premises. It helps, you know, whenever you read a book, you can use it as a bookmark and will bring the memories back of Gwalior to you.
Certainly. It's one of the most beautiful pictures which we have in our hotel of His Highness Maharaj Jivaji Rao Scindia Ji, his wife, Her Highness Maharani Vijayaraje Ji, and the eldest daughter, Padmaraje Ji. We actually haven't changed much in this place. This used to be a library earlier, which was used for people to relax. The purpose of the bar is almost the same. The table, what you see, the billiards table, is brought in about 1930s. Also has been associated with some national level tournaments, because in the earlier era, there were not many actual size tables available. We also have a same table available in Jai Vilas Palace as well. It has remained since that era, and we encourage our guests to come and play. We have a marker which comes in the evening as well to help you to teach the game. Also, the tiles, if you look at them, they give you a 3D illusion, which has been kept from the same era. And the hand paintings on the wall also make a beautiful setting. This is the other courtyard, as I was saying. If you come with a family, we have rooms all across this courtyard, and you can have a good family time together. Two pictures of the army, which was there based in Gwalior during the period of time of His Highness Maharaj Jivaji Rao Scindia. You see him sitting in the center of this. So he was also heading an army which was, you know, in cooperation with the Britishers during the British period of time. Right towards my left is the ruins, which is one of the areas which has not been developed later on. This was more like a hunting lodge during the period of this Navtalab Palace, which was later used as a stable for the horses, and post which it was not used. It's been left like that, and we currently call this as a ruins area. The pool, what you see, is a newly constructed pool. In 2002, we took over this place, and from 2002 to 2004, the hotel was shut, and few more facilities were added in the hotel. So the pool was part of that era. So it was built during 2002 to 2004. What I'm taking you to is the Radha Mahal. Radha Mahal is where our Jiva Spa is now. It was an area which was used by the Maharanis to take bath and to rest. So we'll show you the older part of Radha Mahal and the newly constructed spa. So where we currently stand is the old part. And the Radha Mahal existed in this side of our Jiva Spa. This beautiful piece of art, again the stonework being done here. Also, a very interesting story about Radha Mahal is that it had an underground pathway which connected Radha Mahal to the Jai Vilas Strait. It still exists. It's right beneath this where the pathway goes from. So now we come to the end of our heritage walk here. It's a beautiful memories of the bygone era which I leave you with. Also with an opportunity to come to Gwalior,
listen to the lovely music, see the history of the place, and also enjoy the luxury and the hospitality of Taj Usha Kiran Heritage.